You're probably here because you're thinking to yourself, why is rowing so hard? Rowing can honestly be one of the best exercises you could ever choose, but it can also be one of the most frustrating when you don't understand why this machine is so infuriatingly hard to just figure out. And why sometimes you're like, I barely get a workout on this thing. If that's you, this video is for you. If this is your first time here, welcome. I'm Shane Farmer. This is Dark Horse Rowing, where you build the life that you want to live, and we just happen to use rowing and a little bit of fitness to help you get there. So first, it's actually kind of important to understand why this is so hard to begin with. And it helps to know that others are struggling too, and that it's not just you, I promise. A lot of people really struggle with the rowing movement up front. So let's understand the why so that we can fix it and it's no longer a problem. And so stay tuned, because at the end, I'm actually gonna cover what are the basics that you need to know to start getting more out of your workouts with the rowing machine. It's always good to start with a little history. So let's start there. One of the best places that you can start to actually understand why rowing is so hard is history, because if we can understand history, it'll help give some context to today. Up until the Great Depression, rowing was one of the most popular sports in the United States. There was a lot of gambling and betting that happened with it. And in fact, you would see massive crowds for regattas, including that this was the first collegiate sport that came to the United States. It was even to the level that rowing courses would have train tracks running along the side of the course. And if you had enough money, you could buy a ticket to sit on that train to spectate the entire race as it was going along. So that's to help give you a little context of what rowing once was in the United States. However, with the Great Depression, with going through the World Wars, it lost a lot of its favorability, especially when you started to see the climb and the rise of football, baseball, basketball, team sports that were easily accessible, didn't require a whole lot of equipment, which meant decreased costs because you didn't have to own all this expensive equipment. Then you get into the nifty 50s and it just kind of died off. Now, it may have continued to live at Ivy League schools and smaller schools that could afford to or were near bodies of water and had the money to pay for the equipment, but ultimately that was the downfall of rowing. All of that to say, there's no reason why you ever would have seen rowing as a kid. For example, your dad didn't take you in the backyard to teach you the rowing stroke like he did to throw a baseball or a football or whatever it may be. And you also weren't seeing it on TV on a regular basis. The only time you've probably seen rowing is in the Olympics. And that's every 4 years, you're gonna see a 2-minute clip of a rowing shell going by. You're like, wow, that looks effortless. Next. And that's our exposure to rowing. So why would you understand how the rowing stroke works or the intricacies of the sport itself like you might once have had you lived back in the early 1900s? Instead, today we don't ever see it. It hardly exists in our brains. And so we have no actual context for what does the rowing stroke look like, how does a body move, and how is one successful at the sport? So the next biggest challenge that you're up against when it comes to figuring out rowing and why it's so hard is that the machine will only work as hard as you do. Now, that's not to say that you're not trying to work hard. Let's not confuse the two. But in order to make the machine work, you have to figure out the third part of the puzzle, which is technique. So unless the technique is sorted out, you're not able to put force or work into the machine to make it work in response to you. And that, in my opinion, is generally the biggest hurdle that people face, is that without the technique piece, the third piece of the puzzle, why rowing is so hard, you cannot make the machine work. It's not like a barbell where you can just put weight and weight and weight and weight on and make the thing heavy. In order to make a rowing machine heavy, or to make it resist you so that you actually can like get work done, putting effort into the machine, you have to learn how the machine works, and you have to learn how to make your body move to make the machine work. And finally, I just alluded to it, but the final piece of why rowing is so hard is that it all comes down to technique. And I know that some of you might now be just clicking out of this video and going, nope, I don't want to learn technique. I just want to get a workout. Totally understandable. So if you're still here, good for you. The piece about technique is that without setting a strong foundation, I always say I've never seen somebody sit down on the machine and do it right the first time without coaching. Now, don't get me wrong. Plenty of people figure out ways to get work out of the machine, but in the long term, that sets you back. Without having a good foundation, you're not going to truly be able to thrive and improve over time. You might get a strong bump up at first, but you're just gonna plateau. you're not going to be able to improve, especially at longer distances. And if you really want to sort out like where your power spectrum comes from and getting more work in shorter periods of time, you need the technique to make that happen. As I mentioned earlier, if you're still here, you're gonna get the secrets to what you can do right now to help you improve, lay that foundation, and have more effective workouts going forward. So there are a couple key elements that it comes down to. Now, the first, and this one is just a paradigm shift. I need your brain to grasp this. But when you want to go faster on the machine, it doesn't mean that you physically move faster. So speed of the system, meaning higher RPMs or higher stroke rate, does not equal faster results on the machine, meaning the monitor doesn't give you faster results. What that typically does is you just end up as this hamster wheel effect where you start moving faster than you can actually go, you lose connection, and then it's just you flailing back and forth on the machine. That doesn't actually make you go faster. What makes you go faster on this machine is learning how to put force into every stroke. So it's learning to increase the force or the effort per stroke so that when you introduce higher stroke rates, they are effective strokes, not just disconnected strokes. Understand that, and you're already way beyond most people, and you're going to start to be able to connect. I think I understand that. So work to connect lower stroke rates, and from there, you're going to be able to scale up once you understand the technique. The second, and there's a reason that we have this as a t-shirt on our website, is that the rowing stroke is a push, not a pull. Push, don't pull. It is about pushing through the legs, using your legs to actually push you. You gotta make sure that your legs are pushing you, not that you're trying to pull the handle. And that, again, is a paradigm shift in your brain. If you are learning to push through your legs, that ability is going to make your largest muscle group work for you, and that's gonna put a lot more effort into each stroke. And that goes towards the last point, which is learn how to put more force into each stroke. You can do that by using your legs to push. And I would encourage you, check out our beginner workout videos. There are great ways to learn how to isolate those legs and get some force production happening. Okay, so now if you understand speed of the system doesn't equal speed on the machine, and you understand push, don't pull, the final piece that is going to help you make a big leap and bound change is that rowing comes down to rhythm. If you can understand how to set a specific rhythm, you are going to learn to control your body on the machine. Now, what do I mean by that? Well, typically, because you're putting effort into the drive, the next phase as you slide forward is called the recovery. And the recovery is called so because you recover. There's no ability to actually apply force to the machine as you slide back up to take the next stroke. Therefore, you want to use as little energy as possible, and you can slow way down on the recovery in order to be fast and explosive on the drive, the actual push phase of the stroke. If you can learn that the drive or the push phase is effort, to which you can scale it, and we're getting into nuances here. But if you can understand, I push, and then I relax as I glide forward, and then I push, if you can understand that rhythm, that dance, I always say that the rowing machine likes to be finessed or danced with. It doesn't like to be muscled. If you wanna muscle the machine, again, you can get a workout, but it's not going to last you for the whole spectrum of what rowing workouts can do for you, as well as your longevity on the machine. Learn to dance with the machine, and you will get to a point where you can still smash workouts, but you're doing it with finesse, which is going to help you exceed wherever you are now. It's going to help you exceed that, and it's going to help you in the long term get great workouts, feel better, and make sure that you can use this for a lifetime. Okay, so say it with me now. Speed of the system does not equal speed on the machine. We need to learn to put more force into each stroke, not just take more strokes. That's number one. Number two, push, don't pull. And number three, understand rhythm on the machine. And that can be done with stroke rate practice, which again, we have plenty of workouts. If you do any of our intermediate workouts, you'll find an intermediate playlist here. If you do any of our intermediate workouts, all of those are focused around stroke rate control, and that's a great way to practice that. Now, let's just do a very brief look and talk through the actual mechanics of the stroke, because if you can see it, as I mentioned earlier, right, you've never seen rowing. If I can just show you decent rowing up front, maybe you can start to contextualize it and be able to implement it in your own life. Okay, so again, I just wanna go over this briefly because if you wanna explore this and you really wanna go in deep, that's what our whole channel does. But let's just give you the absolute basics and mechanics of the stroke right now. First and foremost, let's just talk about the positions. Starting up, we've got the catch. This is where you catch the tension that's on the handle, right? If I do this, I can feel that tension that gets established when the handle moves that direction. So the catch is about teaching the body to catch the tension on the handle. What you're looking to do here is set yourself up into the perfect body position. That means hips behind the shoulders, back neutral or spine neutral, head neutral, shoulders down, lats engaged. Those are these guys right here. And you can get them engaged if you take your arms, stick it straight out, and then roll it down, and that gets tight. That's your lat. So those are tight, hands are relaxed, heels are down, and from here, it's all about pushing through the legs. Push, don't pull. So that's the catch position. Now, as you move through the drive, it's all about leg drive first. Then when the knee is about to extend, you're going to swing the hips open from 1 o'clock, for to you that would be 1 o'clock to 11 o'clock. But that doesn't happen until the legs have almost finished working. So push, 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 swing. Okay, pushing, swinging. Then once the hips have swung open from 1 to 11, then you snap the handle through to the body. The base of the sternum is your target, but do not hit yourself. That is going to complete the drive phase. Now, from the drive, you move into what is called the release, and this is just a pass-through position, but the release is releasing the handle from the body, and you're gonna release the handle first with only the arms. Essentially, what happens next is you just reverse the order. So I pushed through the legs, I swung the hips open, snapped the arms in, and then I just go in reverse. I let the arms push away first. Remember, push, don't pull. I'm going to push my handle away, then rock my hips closed, then let the knees bend and glide forward. That's the recovery phase. So the release is that moment at which you pass the handle through and I release it. Then I close the hips into the recovery, and then I shut my legs off as I relax, slide forward, put myself into the catch position, and I've set up a good mechanic stroke. Notice, here's the rhythm piece. Big forceful drive, long relaxed recovery, and I'm pushing every time. Those are the basic mechanics of the stroke. You get those ironed out and you are on the road to success. Once you have ironed these things out, rowing is no longer the same type of hard that it was before you started this video. Hands down, you take these techniques away, you are going to set a foundation strong enough so that you can thrive and survive on this machine, and the same hard will no longer apply. It's no longer this is a black box where you don't understand what is happening and it's frustrating. Instead, it becomes the hard of, wow, that was a hard 2K, and I was able to put a lot of effort into that, and that was the challenge, not the challenge of understanding how it works to begin with. If you're going down this path, make sure you hit that subscribe button so that you get alerted when we come out with new videos, because this is what we do. We help you get there, we help you understand the process so that you can get more fun out of this. And while you're at it, make sure that you check out this beginner playlist of workouts that are gonna help you get a little bit more work in and help you get a bit more established on your machine.